the untold secrets and life story of some of history's most greatest minds. Today we're exploring the extraordinary life of Ibn Sina, also known as Avicenna in the Western world. Who is he? How did he shape our modern world? How did he escape prison? And what are his contributions to humanity? Join us as we journey back to the Islamic Golden Age to uncover the legacy of the Persian polymath. Welcome to Adjusted Film, and this is the story of Avicenna. Born in 980 AD near Bukhara, in what is now Uzbekistan, Ibn Sina was destined to leave a profound legacy. His father, a government official, provided him with access to a substantial education, setting the stage for his future achievements. From an incredibly young age, Ibn Sina exhibited remarkable intelligence. By the age of 10, he'd memorized the Quran. His intellectual curiosity was so intense that by his teenage years, he had exhausted the knowledge of the best scholars in his hometown. And by 16, he was already venturing into the field of medicine. Ibn Sina's thirst for knowledge was insatiable. He explored philosophy, logic, metaphysics, and beyond, shaping his path to become one of the most prolific thinkers of his time. Among his most influential works are the Book of Healing, a comprehensive scientific and philosophical encyclopedia, and the Canon of Medicine, which remained a crucial medical text in Europe and the Middle East for centuries. His works not only enriched Islamic philosophy, but also had a significant impact on Western thought, influencing figures like Thomas Aquinas. Here come some facts about Avicenna. But make sure first you hit the subscribe button. It helps us to grow. Ibn Sina wrote around 450 works in his lifetime, although only half have survived. His writings encompass a wide range of subjects, from philosophy and medicine to astronomy and alchemy. He began practicing medicine at the age of 16. His skills were so advanced that he was allowed to treat the Samanid ruler of Bukhara, which significantly boosted his reputation and provided him access to the royal library, furthering his education. Beyond medicine, Ibn Sina's ideas about metaphysics, especially his theory of the necessary being, significantly impacted thinkers in both the Islamic and Christian worlds. His work helped shape important discussions about the nature of existence and God in these religious traditions. Ibn Sina once had to disguise himself as a Sufi mystic to flee from one of his patrons with whom relations had soured. He spent months hiding in a shepherd's barn, and during another instance was imprisoned for nearly 4 months by a prince for whom he refused to write more books. Ibn Sina's intense work habits and frequent travels took a toll on his health. He passed away relatively young at the age of 57. Despite the political turmoil of his era, Ibn Sina continued to write, teach, and practice medicine until he passed away in 1037 in Hamadan, Persia. Ibn Sina truly revolutionized the world of medicine. His pioneering work laid the groundwork for modern practices in pharmacology, surgery, and even how we understand contagious diseases. Often considered a founding father of these medical fields, Ibn Sina's impact stretches far beyond his time, connecting the rich intellectual traditions of the Islamic Golden Age with today's global medical and philosophical insights. His legacy continues to inspire and influence across cultures and generations, and his name is to be remembered.